Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Outside the surface of a uniformly charged sphere, the electric field is the same as if the charged sphere were a point particle. In order to prove this, let's use an example of a solid, uniformly charged sphere with charge capital Q and radius lowercase a. Let's create a Gaussian surface, which is an imaginary sphere concentric with the charged sphere, where the radius of the imaginary sphere is lowercase r, and lowercase r is greater than the radius of the charged sphere, lowercase a. Bobby, please prove that this charged sphere, outside the surface of the charged sphere, has the same electric field as a point charge.
Okay. According to Gauss's law, the electric flux through the closed surface of the Gaussian sphere equals the integral over the Gaussian sphere of the electric field through the Gaussian sphere times the cosine of theta with respect to area. The direction of the electric field is always outward, and the direction of every infinitesimal area dA is also outward. The angle between those two directions is 0 degrees. The cosine of 0 degrees is 1. The electric field is constant over the entire Gaussian sphere, so we can take that out from the integral. The integral of dA over the Gaussian sphere is just the area of the Gaussian sphere. The surface area of the Gaussian sphere equals 4 pi times the square of the radius of the Gaussian sphere, which is lowercase r. The charge inside the Gaussian sphere is the charge on the charged sphere, or capital Q. We derived that the electric field outside a charged sphere equals the inverse of 4 pi times the permittivity of free space, all times the charge on the sphere divided by the square of the distance from the center of the sphere to the location of the electric field. But we can replace the parenthetical variables with the Coulomb constant, because the Coulomb constant equals the inverse of 4 pi times the permittivity of free space. I just proved that outside the surface of a uniformly charged sphere, the electric field is the same as if the charged sphere were a point particle, and clearly it works at any point outside the sphere, no matter how close to the surface.
Thank you, Bobby. Now realize this is true of a conductor or an insulator. However, the electric field inside a conductor will be zero, and inside an insulator, the electric field depends on the radius and charge distribution and can be derived in a similar manner to what Bobby just did. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.